Talk to us about this new agreement with Dominica. How did it come together and what is the vision?
Sure. I believe this is a historical moment for both Tron and Dominica, since this is the first time a blockchain protocol has collaborated with a Caribbean government on developing the new digital currency infrastructure for the nation. Tron has been a widely used blockchain infrastructure for almost 4 years now. Today, we have 115 million users with a very big use case on stablecoin transact among 5 to 10 billion US dollars every day. But this is the first time we collaborate with the government and to build their designated blockchain infrastructure. And also at the same time, all the Tron cryptocurrency, including TRX, BTT, NFT, JST, and all the stablecoin, TUSD, USDT, and USDD on Tron, has granted a status of medium of exchange and authorized digital currency on Dominica.
What lessons are you taking from El Salvador and, you know, the Bitcoin legal tender situation there, which has had mixed results?
Yes, I think Dominica move is definitely a next level compared to the move of El Salvador. Because in the El Salvador Bitcoin tender bill, it's only focused on Bitcoin. I will take Bitcoin as a very good tools for value storage. But in terms of payment, stablecoin, Web3, and all the new concept comes out, we need a smart contract platform. We need a new blockchain, which with a much like faster speed, cheaper fees, and easy to develop on it. So that's why I believe we can definitely benefit Dominica people with a more powerful blockchain and the Web3 technology.
Given the state of the markets, I'm so curious for your outlook. Are you interested in or trying at all to invest in some of these distressed crypto assets, for example, the Celsius assets that are coming up for sale?
Yes, definitely. I think today is a bear market. So bear market is for buy, right? So instead of like buying all the crypto assets and assets in the bull markets with a formal emotion, I think right now is a good time to buy crypto assets when like everybody wants out. So that's why I definitely believe there is some good opportunity in the markets now. But of course, with thorough due diligence, which is very important, and the understanding of good understanding of the business in the first place. But for Tron and myself, definitely right now we are ready for lots of the opportunity now.
Are you interested in the Celsius assets in particular?
Yes, I think we have done some due diligence on Celsius before. But whether we're going to move forward on this opportunity, I think is still pending.
I'm curious about your role in Huobi, obviously another huge crypto exchange. I know you're an investor in Poloniex. You know, what can you tell us about Huobi, how competitive you think it'll be, what the new owner plans to do with it, especially given China has basically banned crypto?
Yes. So first of all, I'm the advisor to Huobi, and I have joined the company for almost 5 days now. So I start to get familiar with the team and the policy we're going to adopt in the future. I think right now, Huobi has two major focus. One is focused on the HT token, which is the platform token, which I believe is the core value of the platform. We need to push hard on the platform token Huobi, platform HT. If we want to build Huobi as one of the most important exchange in the world. And also the second strategy is globalization. Since, as everyone knows, Huobi is very famous in China before, I think the real success story of Huobi in the next stage is definitely globalization. And also we are planning to go back to China once China has a better policy on cryptocurrency. And I think Huobi will be one of the most important competitive exchange out there when the time comes.
Interesting that you think China's crypto policies will become more friendly. You're not an owner or investor in Huobi, as I understand it, just an advisor. Is that correct? And do you own any HT tokens?
Yes, I own lots of HT tokens for sure. And
How many?
I will say tens of millions. So those HT, I will say some of it I already own before I become the advisor, since I use like HT since day one. When Huobi first founded in 2013, I start to accumulate HT on my own. But right now, I will definitely see myself as one of the biggest HT holder. And also for Huobi, I think definitely for the crypto policy in China, I'm optimistic. Since China is facing a big change, I think in the next month or two, I think after the new leadership, we will definitely see a lot of change in the economic policies and even for lots of industry policy. And I believe crypto and the blockchain is definitely one of on the table.